Good morning.
Good morning.
How are we all doing on this slightly rainy day?
Great.
Yes.
You look lovely. Thanks for being here. I'm Jill Ponce. I'm on platform today. So we want to thank Diane for bringing these beautiful flowers. Let me find the flowers.
Thank you.
Roses. We always love roses. We have Jennifer Sheets again today, the delightful Jennifer Sheets, and you're going to have an opening song called Be a Light.
In a time full of war, be peace. In a time full of doubt, just believe. Yeah, there ain't that much difference between you and me. In a time full of war, be peace. In a world full of hate, be a light. If you do somebody wrong, make it right. Don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. In a world full of hate, be a light.
La 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 la.
In a place that needs change, make a difference. In a time full of noise, just listen. Cause life is but a breeze, better live it. In a place that needs change, make a difference. In a world.
Visitors out there, thank you for being here, and let's go ahead and say our blessing for all of us, all of us, all y'all. That's what I meant. We love you, we bless you, and we welcome you. All right, next up we're going to have the opening prayer by Ela, and in case you missed it, we're going to do a little different version today. We're not doing our vision or our mission, but we're going to try something new. So first we'll start with Ela. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let us pray. We sit here with our minds, hearts, and spirit in complete harmony, melded into the sacred. Our harmony embraces our divine wisdom, our profound courage, and our enduring strength as we encounter infinite opportunities to create a stronger manifestation for peace in this new year. With the love of God, we acknowledge all things are possible. We choose to move forward as peacemakers, and we celebrate each opportunity for peace on earth with an ever-present, harmonious wonder of life. And so it is.
And now Kate Davis with the Daily Word.
Today's Daily Word, January 21st, 2024. The word is energetic. The limitless energy of spirit flows through me. I smile as I watch children at play. Their boundless energy seems so natural, so effortless. When I want to reclaim the same zeal and enthusiasm for myself, I remember these divine gifts are already within me. Centered in this awareness, I feel renewed vitality. As I take care of my family, move through my workday, enjoy time with dear ones, or volunteer in my community, I engage it with enthusiasm and feel my energy build. I will start at the beginning of that paragraph. Centered in this awareness, I feel renewed vitality as I take care of my family, move through my work day, enjoy time with dear ones, or volunteer in my community. I engage it all with enthusiasm and feel my energy building. If I feel my energy, my enthusiasm faltering, I don't despair. Instead, I pause for a moment to feel the quickening energy of spirit, the divine life and strength that are flowing through me. As I am revitalized, the world feels new. I shimmer with energy and go about doing all I feel called to do. From Colossians chapter 1, verse 11, may you be made strong with all the strength that comes from his glorious power. Thank you.
Thank you, Kay. And now up is the Reverend Jeanne with the Golden Key. Hey.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
This is just a little teaching moment we're going to do instead of doing our vision and our mission statement every week. Let's do that once a month, huh? How does that sound?
Yeah.
Prayer. So we're going to have a little teaching moment right now. How many of you are familiar with the Golden Key? Awesome. Okay, we have maybe six of you that know what the Golden Key is. So Emmett Fox created a tool, a spiritual tool, called the Golden Key. Why is it a key? Because it opens doors. It opens doors in your life to harmony, to love, to abundance, in a time when the doors are closed. So, it's so simple. The Golden Key, it's so simple, we forget about it. So, I have an assignment for you this week to use the Golden Key. Maybe you could create a Golden Key, make it your own. Maybe you could use a tool as the Golden Key. Put it around your house to remind you how simple this sweet little spiritual tool is. Okay, so what is it? Let's say someone calls you. I got a call this week that my Uncle Denny has a mass at the base of his esophagus and top of his stomach. And so what's our reaction? Our usual reaction is, oh no, you know. And but I know about the golden key. And I'm going to open my door, not to despair, not to fear. I'm going to open the door to health. And so what do I do with my cousin Jennifer when she tells me about her dad? I say, we're not going to go into that. We're going to open the door to harmony, to peace, to love, and to good health. And all we're going to do is think about qualities of God. Because why? We know we are one with that creative force. So instead of creating with our thought, our feelings, our beliefs, our attitudes, we're going to go in alignment with all qualities of God. And so what you say is, let's golden key Uncle Denny. And then we just create all the things we know about God and Uncle Denny, because we know that that creative spirit is within all of us. And it's in him too, and in the family. So then we just create over and over, God is love, God is health, God is wise. And I know that that health that is of God is also in this mass, whatever's going on. And so what did I just do? I totally changed my whole attitude in alignment with God. So that is your assignment this week, is to use the golden key. Okay? Any questions? Simple! The divine intelligence of God is in all of us. And that's how we use it. It's simple. Yes?
I have a pamphlet, the golden key,
yes,
that was put up by Unity. I don't know how many years ago. Would you like me?
Sure.
Bring it in. So
that would be really neat. That's how I discovered. I mean, okay. We talked about it, and there were pamphlets in the back at Unity of Mesa on the Golden Key by Emmett Fox.
Yeah.
And it's a neat pamphlet. I'd love it if you'd bring it in, yeah. I haven't seen it in years.
There's a pamphlet, and there's another black and white.
Yeah, it's little, too. Because it's simple.
No, I got a little one, and I got a...
Oh, you got a big one. Full. Yeah, it probably has a lot of examples.
I do like to show up.
So yes, golden key, you have an assignment, and I want some reports next week. Okay, Jill?
Oh, all right, the golden key. Ooh. I'm going to get one. I'm going to get a big one. Have it in my house. Yes. Just as a reminder.
Yes.
Next up, we have a meditation song from Jennifer. And then immediately following, we'll have a meditation by Tom. So just silent applause after Jennifer's meditation, and then we'll go into a lesson by the Rev.
The Rev?
It's easy if you try.
This is my golden key. It focuses energy, all sorts of energy, not just spiritual energy. I use it to focus spiritual energy. It is sort of like a natural laser. And the rock that it's sitting on top of is something called TV rock. You can actually set it on top of a book or newspaper, whatever, and you can read through it, the crystal. So what we're going to do today, and at one point I was doing meditations with objects, and I was doing meditations with pieces of paper. You'd write down your sacred, your special object. We'd have it in a bowl or a dish up here. That didn't allow for much participation for those in Radioland, the internet observers. So this way, anybody can take part in this meditation. So what I want you to do is just relax and focus on this rock, which is a crystal called ulexite, but instead of seeing a rock, see your special object in this rock. I want you just to contemplate your object, and it will form a sense of community. Take a deep breath. Relax. Feel the energy of the spirit coming from the earth up through your body and out the crown chakra. Take another deep breath and inhale. Feel the energy reverse and come through the crown chakra, through your body, and out to the earth. This music is called Inner Peace, and that is the key for any kind of healing, any kind of understanding, any kind of progress that you will make in your own life. Have inner peace. So go into the deep alpha and picture the number 10 on a blank slate. Have that number 10 morph into a number 9. Each time it goes into a lower number, you go into a deeper and deeper place. The 9 becomes an 8. You're going deeper and deeper in number 7. Deeper and deeper in number 6. You are feeling a very great inner peace. There are no other things external that are of issue with you. Number 5. Deeper and deeper in number 4. Number 3. 2, 1, you are in a state of deep alpha. Let the music flow through you. Let the energy come through the earth, come from the heavens. You are a conduit, just like this piece of ulexite, this crystal rock. It collimates this energy like a laser beam through your body. and sit here and relax for just a few minutes and let this inner peace be part of you. You can focus your peace and your yourself or a loved one or something else, somebody else. You can focus your energy on just creating a better you. You create world peace if that is what you want to do. This is your meditation. It is for you to do whatever you want to do, whatever is your inner heart's desire to have done. Let this peace fill a void in your being. You desire healing. You know who you are. You know where it hurts or what is lacking in your life, what needs fixing. Focus your energy right now on those parts of your body that need spirit. They need energetic spirit energy to create a sense of wholeness, a sense of oneness. See the lungs being free from any discomfort or disease. See the joints no longer having whatever it is in there that causes pain. See any kind of mind fog that may exist be gone and have clear energy. See the world as you would like to see it. Have the world see you as you would like the world to see you. And that you know you are a creation of the divine. The divine works through you. Another deep breath, breathe in and breathe out. And when you are ready, come back into this room with your feet on the ground and know that you have had a profound change in your life, a change for the better. Open your eyes and be at peace.
Talking about vibrations today. Let's raise our vibes. So the first month of this new year of 2024. And what an exciting year it is going to be. We're blessed. And I think profoundly privileged to be living today. To be able to stand witness to the evolution of humankind. And where does all that start? Inside, right here. So this month we have the opportunity to evolve into a year in which we pronounce every experience good and of God. And by that mental attitude, we will call forth only the good. To quote our founder, Charles Fillmore. So today we're going to lay the foundation of unity, and so I thought it makes sense to start with our five unity principles. So the first unity principle, and I know we've covered this before. Last year, I believe, we covered it. So the first one is, anyone care to remember?
There's one God.
There's one God, Kate said. God is all there is. In all things, God is, and is active everywhere. So the easiest way is to remember on your hand. We start with the thumb, and we say, God is. Number two.
I am.
Our index finger is I am. God is, I am. I am naturally good, because God's divinity is in me. Our very essence is of God. And we just felt that. We just connected with that through God's Tom's meditation. No, that was right. God's meditation. Number three.
Perseverance.
I create. I think. Through my experience. By how I think, my thoughts, my feelings, and my beliefs create my experience. Everything in the manifest world has its beginning in thought. So I think. Number four. I pray. It's a cornerstone in unity. Our prayer life. Through affirmative prayer and meditation, I connect to God. That experience within. And experience oneness as a result. I experience wisdom, healing, abundance, and all things good. So I pray. And number five,
Let it go.
Hmm?
Let it go.
Let it go?
Nope.
I live. I do my best by living the truth that I know. So we take everything that we learn and we live it. It's so easy to just be in your books and have a tiny little experience while you're reading. And I was caught up in that for years. And now we have to live it. We have to be that in our lives. So it's time to put the books away sometimes. And there's a time for going back to the books as well, but we live it, what we learn here. So let's talk about oneness. Universal, from a universal standpoint, oneness means God is all there is nothing other than God. I've heard many stories about when you cross over to the other side, near-death experiences. They say, we're all one. There is no personality. There is no separateness. We are all one. It's all God. So that's the universal standpoint. From the human experience, I am an individual expression of God. Self-reliance, spiritual self-reliance, comes when we practice and develop a deep awareness of the presence of God within. And when you do that, you experience the oneness, because you disconnect from your personality in meditation and align with God, that God presence. I was raised Catholic, and I grew up with a very dualistic view of God. As I was a little girl, I remember thinking God was up there in that big area above the altar. And he was a very judgmental God. He was sitting up there, and he was looking down at me, judging me and condemning me, showering his wrath or his favor upon me. And it was all based on whether I was good enough. And I feared that God. When I was about 26 years old, I had a significant emotional event. Went through a divorce. And I started reading self-help books. And Wayne Dyer was my, I told you this recently, the Your Erroneous Zones was my first self-help book that turned me into a spiritual person. And I started experiencing huge aha moments in my life. I started to learn about a very different God. A God that is infinitely loving. In fact, a God that was the essence of love itself. A God that did not only condemn, but a God that did not judge in the first place. My picture was on his fridge. That's what they told me. My picture's on God's fridge. God is simply the essence of love and acceptance. And of great importance, I learned that God actually wasn't someone or something separate from me. I heard for the first time that God, in fact, incarnated itself as me so that it could have a human, physical, tangible experience through me. Wow! So those were eye-opening, heart-opening, life-changing concepts for me. This awareness changed everything. I look through life through different colored lenses now. And I saw the truth becoming through me. I responded to life very differently. And I reacted to situations differently. And I'm learning to deepen this relationship every day. I am not there, right? I'm still learning every day
along with you. For some reason, it's easy to forget that it's all God. And therefore, so am I, and so are you. I share these things with you, hopefully through my share. You are reminded of yours, your evolution, your experiences. So now I want to talk about prayer. From a universal standpoint, all good is ready to flow into form. And prayer is the vehicle. And from a human standpoint, in prayer, I align my thoughts with God in order to bring God's good into form. So if you want to learn how to do the five-step unity prayer process, you can attend our prayer team meetings with Reverend Julia Norton on Wednesday mornings, 10 a.m. I'm not going to go into the mechanics of the process today, other than to tell you that there are three things that prayer is not. And it is not begging, it is not bargaining, and it's not ingratiating. To this day, I still do it. I catch myself doing it. Oh God, please. Stop it. So prayer is not begging. This is from Children's Letters to God. Please send me a pony. I've never asked for anything before. You can look it up. Prayer is not bargaining. Dear God, if you give me a genie lamp, like Aladdin, I will give you anything you want. Except my money or my chess set. Raphael, did you have something?
There may be a fourth one too, and I came to this realization many years ago. Prayer is also not reminding God because he forgot.
Yes.
We hear that so often. So prayer to heal Aunt whatever every Sunday.
Yep.
I'm sorry, I know you forgot, so.
Exactly. Another child said, prayer is not ingratiation. Dear God, I do not think anybody could be a better God. Well, I just wanted you to know, but I'm not just saying that because you're God. Prayer does not concern itself with unpleasant conditions, nor with imperfect manifestations, either in one's body or the body of one's affairs. But it is for the purpose of inducing an interior awareness, an inner realization in the mind of the one saying the prayer. It's not God that needs to change or be reminded. It's us. Prayer is a way to move our consciousness to a place of accepting that the all good is already here. It's already available. It's already ours. We just have to accept it. Dr. Vitura Papke wrote in materials for a class entitled Prayer Power, How to Create Miracles in Your Life. We need to understand that life is a place of harmony and joy and good, and prayer is down to earth. Matter of fact, it's a way of solving our problems so that we can accept the peace, the love, and beauty that is already ours. We say we believe in prayer, but don't trust it to materialize in our lives. But the truth is, God is not deaf. God answers. So I thought I'd share a personal experience that I had with prayer very recently. A friend of mine of 30 years called me and she said, I need you to come over. I'm going through a thing. I need a hysterectomy, a surgery, and every time I think about it and every time I talk about it, I can't hold it together. I cry. Well, we girls, you know, 30 years of friendship, we love ceremonies.
So I said, okay, I'll come over on Friday night and we'll have a little healing ceremony. And I also like to fast when somebody asks me to do something, because I believe in fasting with intention for spiritual power. So I fasted for 24 hours and we got together and we did our denial. We visited, what are your fears? We put them out there. We're not going to spiritually bypass stuff. Let's just put them out there. So she put out all of her fears, and then we created denial statements, because clearly when we're in fear, we are not connected to God. We're separate. So let's create these denial statements. I deny the fact that I am being controlled by fear. You know, whatever. We created a bunch of them. And then we created our affirmation statements that I am aligned with God. I am the health of God. And we did all these things, and I'd say them, and she would repeat after me. There was tears. There were a lot of tears. And after the ceremony was over, we hugged, whatever. I came to church the next day. And when I got home that night around 6 o'clock, she had called, and we talked, and she said, it's gone. It's just gone. I have no fear at all. And a week later, she had the surgery, and it went wonderfully. And they told her probably 2 weeks before she could get up and about. And she was up that week. She had even gone to the grocery store. She had a miraculous, in her mind, healing. It happens all the time when we put our intention into it. How many of you have experiences like this with your prayer work? Uh-huh, yeah. It's important to talk about it so other people can see it too. It's real. So I found a wonderful poem about prayer written by Kay Ziegler. Affirmative prayer, it's all in the now. Affirmative prayer, it's our sacred cow. We pray with the tips prescribed with the flow to bring to the light whatever we sow. There's no begging or pleading, just stating our cause. We know the truth. There are spiritual laws. So starting this prayer, just follow the rules. Be sharp and listen and use all the tools. Drop into your heart space as far as you can. You'll find there the presence. It's all in the plan. Breathe into that space, into the sacred you. Breathe in the divine to connect you on through. Be aware of God's presence to one that is all. It's spirit forever to answer the call. Believe in the magic, God's great goodness is you. Linger and live there and know that that's true. So important to grasp your godness as fact. Feel it and be it in order to act. So what comes next? Time to reveal the need of this prayer, the heart of the spiel. With passion and feeling, you must state your cause. That which you've desired goes now into the law. You must have conviction. Realization is key. For this is co-creation with God, don't you see? Spirit is willing and eager to please. So this or something better is not just a tease. Now, time to give thanks, as if it's already done. Attitude of gratitude. This prayer part is fun. The last step is easy. Releasing it. 'Tis. I let go. I let God. Yes, so it is. And then we'll talk about the third principle, doing my best and living the truth. The universal idea is, for every visible form, there is an invisible cause or counterpart. And the human standpoint is, that which I give out, I receive back.
It means I'm responsible for my own life. I can't play the victim anymore. It's a double-edged sword. It means that I created the mess that I'm in. It also means that I can change it. It means I'm the arbiter of my fate. Alan Cohen wrote in Daily Dose of Sanity, "What happens to you in the outer world is not a cause. It's an effect of your interior thoughts, feelings, beliefs, and intentions. So pay less attention to how things look and more attention to where your energy is moving, your vibration. The current exterior condition is a result of how you flowed your energy yesterday. Tomorrow's exterior will be a result of how you flow your energy today. So I do my best by living the truth." So these are powerful core concepts of unity, which will change your life and evolve you to another level of beingness when learned and applied. So I want to conclude this morning by laying a few more bricks in our Unity Foundation, written by our co-founder, Charles Fillmore, Unity's Statement of Faith, which is the equivalent to Christianity's mainstream, the Apostles' Creed. I will not read the entire statement of faith. You can look it up. There are actually 32 statements which Charles Fillmore took the Apostles' Creed and metaphysically wrote, which ended up being 32 statements of faith. So I just pulled a sample here. "We believe in God, the one and only omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent spirit of mind. We believe in Christ, the Son of God, in whom is imaged the ideal creation, the perfect man on the throne of dominion. We believe in the Holy Spirit, which baptizes the universe and man with the thoughts of God, and perpetually establishes the divine law in all manifestation. We believe in the 12 disciples, the 12 powers of man, going forth into mind and body with power and authority to teach, preach, heal, and wholly save man and the world from sin, sickness, and death. We believe that God is spirit, as Jesus taught, and that all of his spirit is with us at all times, supplying every need. We believe that divine intelligence is present in every atom of man and matter, and that the more abundant life, which Jesus promised, is flooding the world and quickening the minds and the bodies of men and women everywhere. We believe that the original authority and dominion given to man was over his own thoughts, emotions, feelings, and passions, and that in the lawful exercise of this authority, he will harmonize all discords within and without and restore the kingdom of God right here on earth. We believe in the creative power of thoughts and words, that they do accomplish that whereto they are sent, and that all people are held accountable for even their lightest words. We believe that through indulgence in sense consciousness, men fell into the belief in the reality of matter and material. We believe that the kingdom of God can be attained here and now by overcoming the world, the flesh, and the adversary through Jesus Christ. We believe in the at-one-ment atonement, at-one-ment, that Jesus reestablished between God and man. And that through Jesus, we can regain our original estate as sons of God. We believe that creative mind, God, is masculine and feminine. And that these attributes of being are fundamental in both natural and spiritual man. And God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. We believe that we live, move, and have our being in God mind. Also that God mind lives, moves, and has his being in us to the extent of our consciousness. And finally, we believe that the kingdom of heaven, or harmony, is within us. And that through us, the law and order existing in divine mind are to be established here on earth. There's so many others. There's so many rich, rich things in there. And there's some things that I didn't necessarily know or really align to. But what it said at the very end, which I thought was insightful, was what is important today is not doctrine or language, but seeing with the single eye of truth. Peace, be still, and know that there is truth contained in these statements. If you approach them with wisdom and understanding, God bless.
Thank you, Jeannie. Now, let's follow up that with our monthly affirmation. I pronounce every experience good and of God, and therefore I call forth only the good. What seemed error disappears, and only the good remains. My mind is now and always fixed on the pure, the just, and the upright. All right, now our time of giving. We have the giving baskets coming forward. And we will say our offering blessing, and Jennifer will then sing her song, our offering song. Offering blessing. Divine love, as me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, and all that I circulate. I am so blessed. Thank you, God.
Please, I invite you to sing along if you'd like. We're going to sing through it twice.
To the right of me. Let's just give it a shot.
Okay, over to Cottonwood for breakfast.
Derek, you are a master.
Should we give them a heads up or just a surprise? All right. Breakfast at Cottonwood. We'll get that all figured out someday, right? Okay, and then any more announcements? Prayer team partner today is Barb Castro. Prayer team meeting every Wednesday online with Reverend Julia Norton, 10 o'clock. Reiki Share is with Betty at 9:30 on Wednesdays.
Tuesdays.
Okay, whatever. Tuesdays. Wednesdays. Okay, Metaphysical Group every other Wednesday with Sheila Taylor. And next Sunday, we've got the Yayas and Brian Palmerino. Any other announcements that we have today? Anybody? Anybody? Okay. Good. All right. Thank you to Jennifer Sheets, Jilly Jelly, and Diane, Ela, Kay, Tom, Derek, our sound engineer, as always. We love you.
And Barbara
for doing the prayer partnership. And Sheila.
Yes, the Metaphysical Group meets every second and fourth Wednesday.
Every second and fourth Wednesday.
Of each month. Second and fourth.
Second and fourth. If you go on the first and third, it's going to be a surprise. Nobody will. Second and fourth. Okay. All right. Jennifer Sheets, we got one more song. And then, what else do we have? Oh, yeah, prayer for protection.
Stand by. I'm sure at least a couple of you know this song, so please join in.
Oh, yeah, we do. I know this song.
Be
The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God.